Cowherd, the Cleveland Cavaliers have some problems. Do you think LeBron can fix it?
He's the MacGyver of the NBA. He can fix everything except their deficiencies to Golden State, because Golden State's way better. I think LeBron is doing what LeBron does in January. He leaks stuff. He manipulates. He's trying to get Dan Gilbert to trade that number one pick or top 10 pick. These leaks, I believe, are partially LeBron. He is a manipulator. I'm a LeBron guy. He's a manipulator. All of a sudden, there's multiple leaks to multiple outlets. Why, it's all Kevin Love? I mean, who has the most to lose? LeBron. The two people in this organization that have the most to lose are the owner. He's not leaking this stuff. And LeBron. He is leaking this stuff. So my takeaway is he's trying to engineer a trade. I don't know if it'll happen. But, you know, this is what LeBron does. January, 3 weeks out of the trading deadline, leak stuff, manipulate, get us Paul George. Because LeBron's not dumb. They're not beating
Golden. They're tanking for Paul George.
No, tanking is way too hard. They are competitively creating deficiencies so that Dan Gilbert's forced to trade that pick. Tanking's way too severe.
It's a crazy theory that I actually kind of buy into. I think LeBron is that manipulative and that... shallow's not the word I want to use, but I think he's that manipulative. I don't like it. I don't like the fact that they don't practice. They are seemingly saying the only thing to do here is to get Paul George or Lou Williams or some player that can fix the problem. We can't fix the problem in this locker room. I don't like that.
Jason, I can't believe that you're going along with this theory with Colin. That the Cavs just can't possibly be playing bad. It's got to be that they're doing it on purpose. Is this to be an ulterior motive tactic sort of thing from LeBron?
I think, when you watch them, Colin's theory, I think, is you watch them play against Golden State and you saw that level of engagement and effort, and it's not there in the other games. Why is that? And again, this is in January and February when the games don't matter that much. LeBron doesn't care about seeding. LeBron cares about, can we get Paul George here? Can we get Lou Williams here? Yeah. Can we get someone who can fix this easy rather than...
You know why I don't buy this, though? Is because, actually, no, LeBron cares about stats and he cares about winning MVP this year. And tanking doesn't help him do that. He needs to keep his numbers up. He can't sacrifice his numbers for the sake of tanking.
Tanking seems so severe.
But it is, if that's what you're saying. Yeah. But the question was, can LeBron James fix the locker room issues? And I think he can when he leaves. Then the locker room will be much better.
Well, he could also fix it by committing so that the organization...
Yeah, there's no way
he could, but he's not going to do that. And the thing is, LeBron is an alpha male, which is fine. I think all of us probably are alpha somethings. But people don't necessarily like that all the time in the locker room. And when he's controlling every single aspect of the team and you might get traded the next day because LeBron asks you to, that doesn't really make for a good locker room environment.
Colin, I like your theory. I'm going to see that theory and raise you this.
Oh, boy.
What if LeBron is leaking this stuff, but he's doing it to get the public sentiment on his side because he knows he's leaving. And he's going to say, hey, guys, I tried, but listen, Dan Gilbert wouldn't do this. Isaiah Thomas wanted to practice. This roster is not built. Guys, LeBron is setting the stage for his departure. You can see it's all in the media this week. Well, the Cavs, they're not going to beat the Warriors. We don't know if they're getting out of the East. What if LeBron is getting the public on his side with this through the media? Is that possible? I believe you like that, Kristine.
I buy it, yeah.
All right.
Well, I mean, the other thing is, you know, there's this sense that everybody hates LeBron. LeBron's got a lot of friends in this league, and there are a lot of the smart players. Dwayne Wade's one of the smartest guys in the generationally last 20 years. I mean, ads, smart, winning, recruiting. That's his best friend. The guys that he doesn't get along with, Derrick Rose, I question. He gets along with Shane Battier. He gets along with D-Wade. This idea that everybody's anti-LeBron.
Hold on, who said that? Where did you come up with that?
Well, I mean,
what?
LeBron is...
Kyrie, Kevin Love. Now Tristan Thompson's maybe going to
leave,
too.
Again, Tristan Thompson's an irrelevant NBA player. Kevin Love was in Minnesota forever, couldn't get to the playoffs. The point is, how do we know LeBron doesn't have an alliance in that locker room? He's like, fellas, let's start leaking stuff So our owner, none of those guys care about Dan Gilbert. They do care about each other to some degree.
But then it wouldn't be a locker room issue, right? And it's not a locker room issue because they're all on the same page. I think it's a roster issue.
That's what I think.
They're old, right?
And they know it.
Bad contracts. Isaiah wants to practice. Dude, Dwayne Wade can't practice, okay? He needs a day off.
I'm going to go big picture here. And this is what, again, this I like LeBron mostly. But, again, every solution to every problem isn't always to leave and go someplace else. That's my whole problem with society now. You have one little problem. Well, let's get divorced. And, you know, let's blow this family up. No one sticks through and works through issues anymore. I don't like that about it.
Whitlock, does Isaiah Thomas deserve a video tribute from the Celtics?
Not at all. And Rajon Rondo's 1,000% correct. This is it's a participation. He participated here for 2 years. 2 years, and now we got to put up a tribute video for you. But to even consider this on the same night that Paul Pierce is being honored is just silly and mind blowing to me. No, he does, and I like Isaiah Thomas and great little man, Bob. But 2 years,
great. Well, man, that was a shot.
He is a little man.
I would say this though. In theory, I agree with Rondo. And Rondo's thing is, come on, man, this is the Celtics. It's just like the Yankees hang World Series banners, the Mets, we got into the playoff banners. It is. Now, I agree with that. But because he lost his sister, because how emotionally important he was for the team, his size, the underdog.
Years.
Remember, Jason, there's 41 home dates. You ever gone to a Denver Nuggets Portland Trail Blazer game on a Tuesday? They honor everybody but a ball boy. I mean, you've covered the NBA. There's a lot of Tuesdays at home against the Nuggets. There are nights you could honor a great kid. No?
2 years.
I used to work in the game operations department with the Celtics. Well. So my department was the people who put together all the videos and the tribute videos. Everybody gets one. So I actually do believe that Isaiah Thomas gets one. He deserves that. However, I'm going to let you in on a secret here that I think it's probably starting to come out. LeBron James is obsessed with the Jumbotron, and different teams are starting to learn this. So we knew that anytime he was called for a foul or something happened, he would look straight up at the Jumbotron to try to watch the replay. So instead of giving him the replay, they would actually put the camera right back on LeBron. So he'd look up and just see himself. He's obsessed with that stuff. And I thought that the timing of Isaiah coming back and then skipping the Celtics game is so strategic because that left this game now, Paul Pierce's night, as the only night they could do a tribute video. And I don't think it's crazy to believe that LeBron didn't want to have to go to Boston and deal with this being Paul Pierce's night, so he sabotaged the whole thing and made it so Isaiah would have to have the video played on Paul Pierce's night and that all this drama would now surround Pierce.
See, we both have a conspiracy theory. I like hers.
No, it's not. LeBron loves LeBron, and he's like, I know what the Celtics do to me. I'm not going to give him that. Isaiah, don't play this game. So now you.
I buy into that.
Okay, what about this? A third level of the conspiracy theory.
Yeah, here we go.
What if the Boston Celtics just felt bad for the way it ended with Isaiah Thomas?
Thank you.
We traded this guy after everything. He poured blood, sweat, and tears. You know, his sister's passing, and maybe they just felt bad with the way it ended. It was a bit of a negative move in Boston,
they
right?
Did.
The fans loved him. And what if they're just, we got to give him a tribute.
That's what I think it is. They did,
but like, listen, Brian Scalabrine.
Pretty much. You're right. He does not deserve one. This is a franchise with, 17 banners or something obscene like that?
This is the greatest franchise.
The fans loved Isaiah, and I really do believe he deserves a video. They gave one to Brian Scalabrine and Ray Allen. And Ray Allen, granted, brought them a championship. Yeah, and Tibbs.
What were the highlights of Scalabrine?
But he was the biggest traitor.
Seriously.
Towel waving on the bench, you know? Like,
ML Carr, the ML Carr player of the year.
Listen, I just think...
And you know what? Isaiah, since he's coming out now and saying, hey, we don't practice, maybe he's upset with LeBron, too, saying, man, you put me in all this mix. I have to come out and make a statement that I don't want the video.
There is something called, you know, Isaiah has some insecurity issues to me. To be this heartbroken about getting traded from the Celtics and to still be carrying on about this, it just sounds, and again, that chip on his shoulder from being undersized is why he was a great player. But it's also why he's still whining and crying and why the Celtics, we feel sorry for Isaiah.
Well, they do. I mean,
Let's throw up a tribute video. On some level,
the Celtics trading him away pulled maybe $15 million a year out of his pocket. Listen, nobody's given him any money this summer. He's just not going to get the deal that he should have got from Boston.
Let me give you a psychology in divorce. The person who ends the marriage, they've done studies on this, feels guilty. even if they had an affair. The person
well, they who, should.
They should, and they do. The Celtics dumped him. At some level, I agree with Jason. There is a sense of he was a good kid. He lost his sister.
Hold on. Tell me this then. You're making great points and you're making me look silly. But why is it Paul Pierce night the only night to do this?
Well, because...
Because Isaiah only plays there on two specific games.
Yes.
And LeBron made him not play on the last game. So this is the only game.
Why not move Paul Pierce night to a night when the Cavaliers
move Paul Pierce
are?
People
night.
Bought tickets specifically.
This has been
for
planned
Paul
forever.
Paul Pierce is a top five Celtic.
Since the
of
beginning
all time.
Of the season, this night's been planned. They're not going to move
Paul
it.
Paul Pierce night had to be on the night that LeBron James
is ego.
Well, they're
look
trolling
at the egos
him too. They're trolling LeBron too.
This is a very good story. Right. We should just rename this "Speak for Yourself on Conspiracy."
Conspiracy theory.